Hi. In today's video, we aim to shed light on the complex issue of Linux computer pricing. We often wonder why Linux-based computers tend to be more expensive than their Windows counterparts. To answer this question comprehensively, we'll delve into the various factors that influence these price disparities and evaluate whether Linux computers are genuinely costly. Not long ago, a collaboration between Fedora and Slimbook introduced a computer featuring Fedora's software on Slimbook's hardware. Its initial cost was €1,699, but it could go up to €3,110 with customizations. On the other hand, a visit to Tuxedo's website reveals the InfinityBook S15, powered by an i5-1340p processor, priced at just over €1,000. In comparison to Windows computers, it begs the question, why do Linux computers often seem more expensive? Before we delve into this query, it's important to assess whether Linux-equipped systems are genuinely costly. And if so, are all computers with Linux pre-installed in the same category? Well, not all Linux computers are expensive. Take the Pinebook Pro, for instance, priced at around €200. For this cost, you can acquire a budget-friendly laptop with ARM architecture and a 14-inch screen. It may not be a powerhouse, but it's reminiscent of the price range at which 10-inch laptops, with even more limitations, used to be sold. Nonetheless, it's true that many Linux-equipped computers come with a heftier price tag. Why is that? Aren't we dealing with a free, license-free operating system? Shouldn't they be more affordable? The licensing aspect, in reality, has limited influence. When shoppers browse for new laptops, some of the most expensive options are those designed for gaming, which typically don't include an operating system, thus avoiding Microsoft's licensing fees for Windows. The reality, though, is quite different. Computers with Windows are often cheaper than they would be if the true costs were considered. This discrepancy is at the heart of the matter and largely explains the price variations. Brands strike agreements with Microsoft, mass-produce numerous identical models, and as economics teaches us, an oversupply leads to lower prices. The law of supply and demand is pertinent here. Linux users represent a mere 2-3% of the desktop market share. Even if we were to generously assume that 2% of manufactured computers use Linux, the majority of this 2% likely installed the operating system on a Windows machine. In actuality, the percentage of computers sold with Linux pre-installed is a rarity, representing a minority. When a brand, often in collaboration with a partner like Fedora, decides to launch a Linux-equipped computer, they understand from the outset that sales will be limited, and exclusivity comes at a price. While the prices of high-end Linux systems like the Kubuntu Focus or the Fedora Slimbook can be eye-watering, they are not entirely unreasonable. These prices encompass the brand, exclusivity, and the hardware, which often features top-of-the-line components. In contrast, if we were to consider Apple's offerings, the least expensive Apple laptop, a 13-inch model with an older processor and a price exceeding €1,200, offers a point of comparison. In this context, a Tuxedo laptop with an i5, 16GB of RAM, and a 500GB SSD may not seem as costly. The pricing of Linux computers falls somewhere between that of Apple, which tends to be higher, and Windows-based machines, which lean closer to affordability. Considering the broader landscape, it's arguable that Linux computers are priced reasonably. While models with high-end hardware might seem expensive, there are also more budget-friendly options available. To clarify, this isn't to say that every reader's next computer must come with Linux. In fact, my next computer may very well come with Windows by default. However, Linux computers are typically priced within the range they should be, all things considered. To wrap it up, the pricing of Linux computers is influenced by a myriad of factors, including market dynamics, supply and demand, and the specific components and features they offer. If you haven't already, please consider subscribing to our channel. We upload new content regularly, and subscribing is the best way to stay updated.